Hi, today I want to show you my Bluetooth setup in BMW E87 with the basic business CD radio, which does not have the Bluetooth capability in this car because it was an optional equipment and I just don't have this option in my car. Let me just show you how it works first and then I will tell you how exactly it's installed in this car. So let's turn on Bluetooth in my phone. Bluetooth is on and let's start the car to power up this device, which is a Bluetooth receiver. Okay, so as you can see, Bluetooth device is connected and now when I use my phone, for example with YouTube, it should use my car audio. Okay, let's check if Siri works. What time is it right now in Sydney, Australia?
The time in Sydney, Australia is 0:30.
Let's check if I can use it as a phone.
I'm sorry, you have entered an invalid phone.
За 500 метров скręć в prawo. Bogusław Wołoszański jest autorem programu Sensacje XX wieku czy Rewizja Nadzwyczajna?
Sensacje
XX wieku.
Tak jest, Rewizja Nadzwyczajna to program Dariusza Baliszewskiego.
So, as you can see and hear, all of my phone's sounds are going wirelessly through the Bluetooth device to my car audio, which I can control with this volume knob. This includes music, YouTube videos, navigation guidance, and of course phone calls. Okay, so the most important device over here is this Bluetooth receiver. And I needed to slightly modify it to fit my needs. What I did is solder four set of wires, and one is over here, this is for power. This one is for the audio signal. Over here there's a microphone signal and those color wires are for the button override. And of course I could use the 3.5mm jack and the micro USB connector to power it and connect the signal, but I wanted to make a permanent install that will not have the risk of something disconnecting because of pulling on wires. And right now I'm using only this wire, and this wire. I'm not using the button overrides which are on this board because this is for a future integration with my car. And the basic idea is that I want to control my phone, my music, my phone calls with buttons that are here, those empty buttons. And when I activate those, I will connect those buttons to this connector, which will give me the possibility of controlling my phone over those buttons. Okay, so now you know that I have to slightly modify this receiver, but what about the wiring? So the first and the simplest thing is to connect this audio line to the AUX input. You can do it directly. I didn't want to have a 3.5mm jack going out from here to here. So what I did was disassemble this thing and this thing under the handbrake, guide a 3-pin wire over here and solder it to the AUX input wires. Next thing was the power to this device. So first of all, I want this device to be always on when my car is on, so I needed a power that is ignition hot. To do that, I used a fuse tab to connect with a cigarette lighter fuse. So every time I turn on the ignition, the cigarette lighter is on, and also those wires are powering my device. Of course, cigarette lighter is 12 volts, and this is normally powered by USB, so this is 5 volts. So I had to use a little transformer, which is installed behind the glove box in my car. And the third wire, the longest one, was this one. This is the microphone, which I had to guide with the power wire over here, just under the dashboard, under the glove box. And of course, power wire goes to the fuse box, which is behind the glove box, and the microphone wire goes all the way to the door, then up with the A pillar over here behind the airbag, and then it goes over here and it goes out over here. And as you can see, I had to remove the dome light to access the factory microphone installation points. And the microphone is installed over here. This is this small little shiny thing over here. And as you can see, you can barely notice it. Everything looks like almost like a factory installation. Wiring the car was the hardest thing over here, so I had to disassemble the A-pillar cover. There's a separate video about removing that when I had to fix the noise. To remove the dome light, you had to unscrew this and this sun visor holders. And with them removed, you can just bend this part, stretch it, access the dome light and push it out. Dome light uses two clips to fix it securely to the roof, so you have to reach those, press those and push it downwards to have it like this. And of course, be careful because there's a lot of wiring over here. You don't want to pull it too hard. You might need to disconnect those, or just be very, very careful to not damage anything. To install this device, I choose this place because it's close to me, close to the passenger also. So the Bluetooth reception should be the best over here, and if there's something wrong with it, I can always access it easily, because all you need to do is pry those clips and you can remove this part to access whatever is underneath. As you can see, this device has a USB port and a microSD card slot, so you can use each of those to play MP3 files from your memory stick or memory card. Okay, so right now I have to put everything back together, place this device securely over here. Thank you for watching, hope that you like my installation in this BMW E87, and if you have some comments, just leave it below the video. See you soon!
W którym mieście odbyły się pierwsze na świecie igrzyska olimpijskie transmitowane w telewizji. Berlin 1936.
Dokładnie to chciałem powiedzieć.